Hi everyone. So I'm in the greenhouse today. Yesterday, if you caught my video, I planted some bulbs in the side yard, and that's the west side of the house. So I just thought I'd start in the greenhouse today because we did get our first frost last night. So it was as per schedule. They say in Northern Illinois in zone 5B, that our average first frost is middle of October. So we did get it last night. It went down to 29 degrees. And luckily I was good about bringing in some of the plants that I wanted to overwinter. My white geraniums that were on the patio in clay pots, I brought those into the greenhouse that I'll show you, and also my foxtail fern that I planted earlier this summer that was sitting right in front of the greenhouse. I wanted to overwinter that. It's one of my favorite ferns. So I don't have heat yet in the greenhouse. You see the plug right above there is for the fan. Greg is going to try and save us about $2,000. So hopefully he can get that installed. But today, you know, although it's today it's around 56 degrees outside Fahrenheit. And so it's quite cool again. I did walk Eddie this morning and wore a vest over top my sweatshirt here. But in terms of dryness, it is in the dry zone. It's about 15 on the RH hygrometer. This is what I have here. So yeah, it says it's 90 Fahrenheit. It doesn't feel it, but that's probably under the intense sun. So I'll take you around the greenhouse quickly, and then we're going to take a look in the garden to see what the first frost did. At first glance, I know my sunshine and patience got fried. Is it fried or froze? Yeah, they froze from the 29 degree temperatures overnight. And my mandevilla on the back patio, the north facing patio that's fully shaded right now, I'd heard that they can survive some light frost, so they seem to have survived. I'm still debating. I know I don't have room in the corners or anywhere here because of all this furniture. And I suppose I could take out a table. But no, I don't think I will, because my table area, not only can I display some of my pots or my trays, you know, it's because I'm planning to do some, obviously do some, not just fill up my my grow lights shelving, but I plan to do some seeding all through the winter into early spring. So all these surfaces that look pretty are not just for props, for decor, but also to actually hold my seedling trays. I have shelving along the top that I believe can hold my seedling trays as well. So it's all functional in here. And wow, I can feel the heat on my back. Feels wonderful after being outside. So we'll take a look also at some of the areas that I continued to plant some bulbs after filming my video yesterday. And so I did plant some daffodils in the back corner where my rising sun redbud is, and also some of the other tulips that are on each side of my arbors that go into the raised bed area. So we'll take a look there. I know I've got some cleanup to do. I really have to get rid of the zinnias, because I'm not planning to collect any seed. It's a lot of work, and I know I can do it, but I do have some seeds left over from this past spring, and I know I didn't buy any more because I had a lot. So I do want to use those up first, and then I know they have a good chance of germinating. So in any case, thanks for joining me today, and let's take a look in the greenhouse and see what damage in the garden the frost has caused and what I need to do. So here we are with my basil that I started from seed earlier this spring, probably in February. Still not looking great. I still haven't applied any of this grow fertilizer. That's on my list of things to do. I think I need to get my journal out, put it here in the greenhouse, and start checking things off. Second thing to do, change the water in my little rootings here. This basil's doing great. Got to water again. Haven't done anything with these seeds. I've never collected seeds from sunflowers. I should have left those for the birds, but they have plenty to feed on. So this blew my mind. She remembered. Is probably ready to go soon, but because I still see flowers, I can't pull myself, bring myself to tear it out. So maybe I'll put some narcissus in here. I think that'd be a great idea. Blue on blue, like it is now. There's my Meyer lemon tree, still looking great. I did read up since the last video that I need to get some. I'm going to look at my Jack's fertilizer, but they do have some citrus fertilizer, which of course they sell every kind of fertilizer. But I'm going to check out my Jack's all-purpose fertilizer, see if that works. That's probably what I used last time. So there are, sorry about the shadows, but there are my two geraniums, my white geraniums that didn't cost a lot, but they just did so well. And sometimes white geraniums are hard to find. And I got those from Costco. They were just like one plant. Anyway, there is my foxtail fern that I love so much. And I'm not sure if I ever showed my little succulents. There's my myrtle and my little house plants, my other. So that's about it. And my house plants. So these are the shelves here that I believe I can, right now they just display some of my pretty pottery and pictures, but I can do trays up there as well as those up there. And this whole surface here and this surface and down here. When I'm doing my pansies at like darkness, I can have them sit down here because it doesn't get direct sunlight. And I can also cover with another tray. So there's all my trays. And I even have this area down under that I can, hold. I very carefully chose this work area, this workbench. I call it my workbench. It's a kitchen shelving storage unit, and I can, put some trays down under there. So it's getting warm in here. Oh, there's one of the hydrangeas. This was the Let's Dance Lovable that I saved. And look how my alyssum just self-seeded from another pot and self-seeded blew into this pot. So I'm going to have to remember to water more frequently. Since it is still warm in here, I did bring in my geranium that was hanging beside my Bar Harbor Belle on the side of the porch there. And I removed that one properly and hang that goldfish plant up there. I gotta find the tag. I know I didn't throw it out, it's probably in the house somewhere. But it is, I believe, a goldfish. And do you see the orange flowers? Oh, there's another one. So, there you go. You can hear Eddie barking. And my aloe plant looking. I don't know. I have no idea what I'm doing, honestly, with houseplants. They get a little scorched in here if they're here in the summertime, but I brought them in when it got cooler. So I opened the windows because I had shut them tight last night so that nothing, no frost would get in. And those vents are still, oh, they did open up. One of them opened up. They are temperature regulated. They just automatically open and shut. They have like a wax seal on them, and they automatically open and shut based on the outside temperatures. So anyway, let's head outside and see what's happened. So my ajuga, that's just, I think that's an overflow of the one by my obelisk. It did not get scorched. Look at those. My bubblegum super tunias did not get completely scorched. Some snapdragons are still growing in this pot. They did not get scorched, and that's because snapdragons are a cool flower, so they can handle. And my Louise OJ rose, which has not been fertilized because I quite honestly forgot, and it was so late in the season when I planted them. And this chicken wire cage that I made, I need to stake that. So let's take a look. Turtle head is okay. Ooh, still blooming Roseanne. The geranium, or sorry, the quick fire, or the firelight tidbits, sorry, are fine. And this other turtle head, there is a leaf, a couple leaves coming up. I should cage those. I have some leftover chicken wire. My Amsonia string theory, it's doing fine. My new blooms on let's dance sky view. The other two did not get second blooms. This is Delish Rose. So what I did last year with all my roses is I ordered from Heirloom Roses, where all my roses are from, well, most of them. They sell this mint compost, and I surrounded the base of all of my roses to help overwinter them. I was extremely nervous last year since it was my first winter with new roses, and they all survived, even the one that the bunny ate to the ground. So there you go. There's some damage from the sweet potato vine. However, the mandevilla is okay. So these pots that I keep talking about are too heavy and too large to fit in the greenhouse. So, and I do plant in the spring, and I will repeat, I will be planting my sweet peas in here, and they're a deep-rooted annual, and I will plant them in this pot because it's nice and deep, and they did really well last spring into June. So I do need three. I will do in three pots. That one there in the corner. This is where my new hose length that my husband bought me for my birthday will go. Will no longer be fighting with that hose. So yeah, let's take a look here. So this mandevilla did okay. It's surviving. So the only solution to try and save these, and I did get these for half price on the clearance rack in Lowe's because I had taken out my seedlings that were finished, my spring pansies and my sweet peas. I planted these mandevillas, and I would have to cut all of these vines and repot it into another pot and put them in the greenhouse. So we'll see. Maybe I will do at least one and see how that goes. I was just thinking it would be nice to put a smaller trellis or obelisk in my front urns and grow those two pink ones and then the white one in the corner. So we'll see. I'm gonna try to do that. Luckily they survived and it gives me another chance. So my annuals here are pretty much done. And these pots with my standard boxwoods, I was nervous about, but I'm almost thinking that they're going to be okay because it's pretty sheltered here. It gets sheltered from the wind, as you can see, and it gets in the summer it gets morning sun until 2 o'clock, but because it's fall, the sun has is no longer here. I don't know if it gets morning sun in the winter. I think it would for a short period. my sunshine and patience. Didn't bring them in there. The Blue My Minds are still doing okay, whereas the sunshine and patience got a little bit, little frozen, but not like the ones out front that I'll show you. So here's the hanging basket that was pretty hard to keep watered in there. It's done. And yeah, we had cut back these annuals earlier this year. My stepdaughter had cut them back and they grew back nicely. And so yeah, they didn't get scorched. And my African daisies are still okay. And there's a couple of these zinnias that got eaten by bugs, but they don't look like they will not bloom. Over here, the Twists and Shouts, they're fine. My sedum, Autumn Fire. So in this little area here, I planted some daffodils because the bright yellow will cheer up this area. I need to come in here and cut back these golden hostas. They're getting very golden, but look at the foxgloves. They're doing great in my heuchera and this hosta. Once they get golden like this and before they get super slimy, I cut those back. My Endless Summer hydrangeas are hanging in. New growth. So this is done. This is my Bali hibiscus. So there is a view of my sunshine and patience. They need to come out. And I think the sky, I don't know, we'll see. And this sky, I've planted them equidistant apart, but kind of put this in between the impatience and it's struggling versus this really healthy one. Try and get my shadow out of the way. So these need to come out. And look at that new cane from Kiss Me Kate. And I tried to train those horizontally as much as I could. And I think my trellis is just a little short. But and I don't know. Let me know if you guys cut back your peonies now. Do you wait a little longer? Look at those snapdragons still kicking in lots of new growth. Oh, this is the pot that I'm going, one of the pots, one of two pots out front here that I'm going to plant some tulip bulbs. When I took them out from here after they finished blooming last spring, this past spring, I put them in a paper bag in the garage and I was going to put them in the ground, but I may end up just trashing them because I didn't keep them cool enough. I'll check to see if they're rotted. But I have plenty of bulbs, as you saw in yesterday's video. So look at that. The Supertunia bubblegum is still alive. And it's because it gets full sun here, I think, and it's sheltered in this little corner of my south-facing porch. And that that standard boxwood, this is a really heavy pot. So I need to cut it back. I'm kind of hoping that it survives. It's a super heavy pot, as I mentioned, and I have two others in the back that are in plastic containers, and I can probably carry those very easily. So if I at least two survive out of the three, I'll be fairly happy. And this one here, as you recall, is the pot where I planted bulbs and left in on top on the porch over the winter. So it was my experimental pot and the tulips rotted and didn't make it. And too heavy to carry in versus these two in front. which I carried into the garage and then brought them back out. So I'll do that again this year if I plant bulbs in these two front pots. So that corner one may end up being my sacrificial lamb again, and I will leave this standard boxwood over here and even the ivy. I don't know, maybe I'll dig up the ivy because they're really nice trailers, or I may just leave it because I have some other ivy around the mandevillas. So yeah, I might just cut this back a little bit and see if it does okay. And speaking of boxwoods, I have this one here and I have that one in the corner that's shaded. And normally we plant, or we bring over our evergreens that are in pots, and we leave them here, and sometimes they get scorched from the frost. So these are, I believe this is a Chicago boxwood variety that are supposed to be very hardy in our zone. So I'm going to, I think, keep them here for winter interest, and we usually light them up. So I have one of those wheeled trays underneath that I can move them around. But I don't know. Maybe I'll put some burlap. I don't know. We'll see how bad it is. Usually Eddie peeks in there. So let's take a look. My mums and my kale are still doing okay. And my blew my mind. My rose. Tchaikovsky. This is the sweet romance plant I finally put in the ground. These are still doing okay. Let's see if Darwin, the bug. Nope, she's fine. He's fine. My spiraeas are turning fall, getting their fall foliage. These are at last roses. They're doing fine. These were already scorched. I watered them yesterday. Let's take a look at the roses. Oh, look at that. Still doing okay. So, quick glance at the roses. Need to stake this or put some zip ties. Look at New Dawn. So glad I took you along. Oh, look at her. She was not open yesterday when I was planting. There's another bud. I need to cut these back. Poet's wife. So here's where I planted my bulbs. And I'm going to do a quick inspection. Whoop, very soft. Wearing my boots. Make sure no squirrels dug up my bulbs. This is where I put the hyacinths, more bulbs, and over here is where I planted some of the other tulips, not the tall Darwin ones, but the finolas. I planted the finola tulips here, double late finolas on each side. I did a bunch of seven. And Greg took some of the sod that he dug up and just turned it over here that will compost out in my pumpkin bed and will become a filler flower bed, and so will this. Will continue to be a filler flower bed. I'll continue to grow bachelor's buttons here in early spring, probably in February or March. I'll put them in the ground after starting them in the greenhouse. This zinnia, purple zinnia, is still doing great. So I still have some. And my African daisies are still doing great. The cosmos, pretty much done. They fell over. They're done. Gotta dig that, put that in a bag. So they already picked up the lawn and leaf bags that are full of grass and compost. Some of the tomatoes and marigolds. So I've got to clean that up. Greg did not get to finish. We had the girls for Columbus Day, so he didn't get to finish this path, but he got it sort of mapped out. So I need to clean that up. It is warm under the hot sun here, so this zinnia bed needs to get cleaned up. And I will salvage any blooms, but so far, I don't think I can salvage. Oh, there's one. Another. But as you can see here, completely my tags, gotta salvage those. It's really sad, but it's that time of year. And the bunnies, are you in here today? Oh, I can actually see the base. I think I can cut a bouquet. Unbelievable. If you've got some space or containers, I highly recommend growing snapdragons from seed. They are phenomenal. Like, I planted these in early May. I thinned them out. I will show you again how I did that. Instead of snipping the extra seedling in a cell, instead of snipping the under, you know, there's two or three little seedlings, and you keep the stronger one and you snip off the others. That's what most gardeners do, but I just separated them and repotted the extra seedlings, and I got went from 2 24 cell trays to 6 trays and little pots, and I transferred them over here, the extra trays, because 1 4x8 is the equivalent of 2 24 cell trays. So 48 plants go in here, or a 10-20 tray fits. I had 10-20 trays filled with stock over here, and they were not a cut and come again. They were a one and done. So I will not do stocks again. But look at all the new buds on my zinnias here. But they got powdery mildew, which is disappointing, because this was a later set of seedlings. They were all direct sowed in this bed. So hollyhocks are still pushing out, but I think I'm going to clean this up today. That's my job today. And maybe plant some more bulbs in the front bed. So here I planted more of those. I think I planted 7 of the other tulips, the ones I just mentioned. I've got a brain fart, and I planted 7 more over here. Greg is going to finish off these corners with more of that landscape stone. And over here, I planted daffodils in this corner on the right here. Sorry, I'm trying to get out of the sun, out of the shadow. I planted some to the right of this Baptisia, some to the left, and then another bunch over here between the candy tuft and the lilac on the left in front of the Veronica. So right there in the middle, I planted some more. And I thought of planting some back here, but why? You can't see them. You'll get enough foliage with the forsythia in the spring and the red bud in the spring. And the blue meringue lilacs. So I have a lot of spring blooms over here. So, oh my gosh, with the between the purpley pink and maybe my Baptisia will bloom next year. I have white candy tuft, purples, and yellow with the and pinky purple blooms, hopefully with the rising sun, and the yellow daffodils and white daffodils and apricot. So it's amazing how the blue continues to get to come out on the new growth of the Fat Albert. So, oh my goodness, this is sad. So this is a big job. I need to clean out this deathly spent bunch of tomatoes. So I have a big job today. I don't even know if I'm going to get any bulbs done, but I'm going to clean up this area and then show you a shot of what it looks like after, when everything is pretty much emptied out. So I grabbed my lawn and leaf bag and I'm going to start cutting some of these frozen tomatoes. We're actually going to be in the 70s this week. The side's not as bad, but some of it, I'm just going to start.
Thank you. What do you think, Eddie?
That was a lot of work today. And more tomorrow. We have all this to clean up.
Well, that was quite the day. I hope you made it to the end of this video. I was able to finish off the cut flower bed in terms of cleaning it up with all the zinnias that had powdery mildew and anything that got frost after last night's first frost. My filler flower bed is also empty now. I ended up taking the salvia, the celosian, amaranth, and cosmos all down. And I think I filled 8 bags of lawn and leaf bags to go to the compost pile. So I also was able to at least get one last basket of cut flowers. And I harvested a lot of tomatoes, as you saw. And maybe I'll even fry some green tomatoes. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one. And happy fall. I hope you've got a chance to start your cleanup. It's very tiring, I have to admit, but at least I put a dent in it. So we'll see you again next time. Thanks for joining me.